Pretty amazing.
Okay, so these are some of our common chicks. The guy that you just saw has hatched yesterday, and this guy right here is a couple of days old.
Yep. And this is an example of a chick, which is the firstborn, and is usually the stronger, heavier of the chicks. And this is B chick, who is smaller and will probably weigh less, and has a smaller chance of surviving or fledging or growing up to fly away. And this is an example of a nest being in our pathway. We deal with it during the season that there's nests usually everywhere that we walk, and they are all over the beach, they're all over the island. And in the middle of the season, when like there's the most amount of nests, you really have to watch where you walk.
Every step you take,
you have to, it's pretty much suggested to step where the person in front of you steps, so that you decrease the amount of risk in stepping on chicks and eggs. Because on the top of the island, the vegetation tends to get overgrown, so there can be nests under leaves or under vines, so you pretty much have to kind of dig through. And on the rocks and stuff, the nests and the chicks and the eggs kind of blend in with the environment, so it also increases the risk of stepping on them. So it's best to stay to large rocks and just be cautious of where you put your foot down. Look in front of you before you put your foot down. This is a common tern chick, Sterna rundo, and he is a state listed species of special concern. But in recent years, the populations have been increasing every time we do the common tern survey, so it's a good sign.
How do you tell the difference between this, that this is a common and not a roseate?
As far as the chicks are concerned, you can tell by the his coloring. He's kind of a tan with black spots, whereas the roseate is more black with gray spots, or gray streaks, kind of. And then the common chicks have reddish, pinkish legs, whereas the roseates have more black, grayish-black legs. Yeah, those are the biggest differences.
So currently, Faulkner Island is at a low tide stage, and it's better to walk around at low tide because there's more of the rock exposed, and you can walk closer to the water because the birds like to tend to nest closer to the vegetation because they know that the tide will come up, and the tide can, at high tide, can come up to this seamount right here. So it's best to do rounds or to try to do rounds when it's low tide, so there's less of a risk of stepping on chicks and nests and eggs.
And you also disturb the birds more the closer you are to the nest. So staying further away, you'll disturb them less. And as far as the roses are concerned, we try to stay far away from the nest as much as possible because, you know, we don't want to stress them so they don't come back again next year. We want to keep increasing the numbers. And actually, several of the nests have been destroyed from extremely high tides. So even though, you know, there's still a risk of them not having nested far enough up on the island.
And we've had some really high tides this year because of the rain. Yep. Like yesterday was a pretty high tide.
Mm-hmm.
Did you notice that?
Yep. Yeah. It was pretty high, and I mean, it keeps pushing closer and closer to the island.
Now, other than the fact that I'm a chicken, why am I carrying this pipe?
Because both the bird species that are out there like to attack the highest point. So they kind of go for your head, and if you have a stick, they'll go for the top of the stick, so you kind of protect yourself.
Okay. So it's not a cut.
No. So, when we walk along the island, they tend to like fly up and try to flock at you. So it's best to like maybe hold it above your head and maybe do a little bit of careful waving action to kind of get them away from you.
If you dip your head down, tip your head over, tip your head down so we can see the top of your hat. That's all from the bird.
Yep. This is a field season worth of bird pecking and pooping.
And this is 10 days worth of pooping.
So the numbers represent the radio grid that we have on the island, and it's kind of to indicate locations of nests on the island. So around the beach, we have numbers in blue and and X's and marks in yellow and blue spray paint. And it helps us on the island and the beach, because we can figure out where the location of certain productivity plots are, as in Northwest Shelf, Radio Grid 15 is one of our nest locations.
And it also, it helps with the roseates because they tend to spread out.
Mm-hmm.
So we can say, oh, we're in 45 today. We're going to 45. And they're about 10 meter by 10 meter long. I guess rectangles nowadays, low tide. So it's evenly spaced out around the whole island.
Yep.
It's about medium size, maybe 10 days old.
And now I can't see them at all. I mean, they really blend in so well.
Faulkner Island is restricted to public access because it is the breeding ground for the common and roseate terns. And since roseates are endangered and commons are a species of concern, we want to try to minimize human contact and people walking around. So this is a restricted space, and people cannot land on the island nor use it for public uses.
And the more the birds get disturbed, the less likely they are to return to the island. And like you said, there's so many nests everywhere that if someone who didn't know what they were looking for came onto the island, chances are they would step on a lot of eggs.
It's like the... Are you rolling?
It's interesting because the erosion was coming from above. They thought it was from the tide and the waves, but it was from the rainwater.
Yeah.
If the rainwater came over the top, it was taking much of the island with it.
Yeah.
That's why on the south side, so much of it was lost.
Yeah.
And that's where they put all the big stones to preserve that side. And it was a major project.
Yeah.
Just to get something out here, a piece of equipment out here, sometimes they fly it out with a helicopter. Or they bring it out in a fishing wildlife landing craft.
Okay. There was a project with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and they set up this revetment, which is basically a rock barrier to minimize erosion. And they were supposed to be smaller rocks, but we have these large rocks all over the island that is meant to minimize the erosion to the island, because the island currently is 2.45 acres in size, but it used to be bigger. Decades ago.
Interesting. And the lighthouse was built and commissioned in 1802, right?
By Thomas Jefferson.
That's pretty fascinating when you think about it.
There's a lot of history on this island.